Greetings, Baroness of the Unchosen.
I, Commander Hellcat, am prepared to march with you into battle and take over the plains of the Blooded Cloak and their precious oil deposits.
No, I think you mean take over the Cave of the Mind's Edge. So, from the top.
No, the Cave of Mind's Edge was only part of Commander Hellcat's campaign in the Fist of the Wasteland limited run TV series, not the original film trilogy.
Okay, it's just that the Fist of the Wasteland's movies was actually based on the graphic novels where Commander Hellcat takes out the Cave of the Mind's Edge with her Doom Buggy Battalion.
Those graphic novels were based on a board game where players had to take over the Blooded Cloak in order to win the Oil Apocalypse card, which you, need in order to win the game.
Oh yeah, because that board game was actually based on a dystopian theme line of pool toys, one of which was an inflatable tube called, you guessed it, the Cave of the Mind's Edge.
Those pool toys were based off a cruise line then called Punchers of the Apocalypse, which had a Baccarat lounge, which was called the Blooded Cloak.
But if you would just take a look at the Fist of the Wasteland's dinnerware line.
Oh, which was based off the Fist of Wasteland scented candles.
Which was based off the line of mouthwash.
Okay, which was based off a group of soup restaurants in the Phoenix metro area.
Enough. Here, you know what? Have a Snickers.
Okay, look, no matter what adaptation you based your story off, I think we can both agree that the worst one was that Magictopia theme park ride.
For sure, it's insane how many test dummies got completely incinerated in the Cave of the Mind's Edge section.
I mean, it caused a test dummy shortage that continues to this day.
R.I.P., you beautiful. Brave rubber bastards.
You're that dystopian wasteland fan when you're hungry. Eat a Snickers.